Hello, I'm Ken Smith from Wally World Gallery in Ormond Beach. Today we're going to start a series of videos on how to hang pictures in your home. I'd like to start with the essentials just today are the tools you need to hang pictures in your home. If you get a quality framing job from a local picture framer, they usually set you up with everything you need, a nice safe wire to hang it by and the appropriate sized hanger to use. Sometimes we'll use two hangers, and I'll get into that later when we go to hang pictures. But something small like this, one hanger will be just fine. This is a nice picture of my mother and my godmother. Love it. So when you're in that situation, you're ready to hang pictures in your house. All you really need are the tools that are in front of me here. A nice lead pencil, torpedo level, hammer, and a good tape measure. And I say a good tape measure because some of the lousy tape measures, if you want to do something larger than a foot or so, you're going to fight with it quite a bit. So a nice solid tape measure is always helpful to have. These are the basic tools that you need just to hang a picture in your house. Now, if you have a large hanging job, you're going to someone else's house to hang pictures, or you yourself have just moved and you want to do the entire house, we'll get a little more elaborate and show you what's in a professional toolkit. My wonderful wife has set me up with this bucket of tools. Everything I could possibly need while hanging pictures. We've added to this over the years, and I think this is just about everything you could possibly need. To start off with, I have my lead pencil, but because I'm a professional, this lead pencil is not sharpened using a pencil sharpener. It's sharpened using a razor blade or anything else I have hanging around, because that's how professionals do it. And this does not go in the bucket, it goes behind your ear. That way everyone knows you're here to work. Now, beyond the lead pencil, if you have a dark wall in your house, or you have a wallpapered wall in your house, the lead pencil may not be able to, you may not be able to see it when you make your mark on the wall. So for that, I have a white chalk pencil. That helps a lot when it comes to making those little marks in odd different colored walls. I also carry with me a pen usually, though I hardly ever use that, but it's there. I have multiple levels. You saw the torpedo level earlier. I also like this level. I can't really tell you why, other than it is slightly larger than the torpedo level with squared off corners, and I like that. So you'll see me use this a lot when we get into more hanging videos. For much larger pictures, I have this nice 16-inch level. That helps again for two hooks spaced out nicely. I've got my stud finder, which obviously it works. I've got my awl or poker, ice pick, things of that nature. This is great when it comes time to screw into a wall. You need to drill a hole, you need to hit a stud, you need a poker. That's helpful. Various screwdrivers, that's always a good thing to have, again, for screws. Never have just one pencil. You have to have lots of pencils. That's a must when you're on a job site. I'll start with the outside of the bucket here. We'll go from there. I've got a nice eraser, a typing eraser, strong eraser, good for removing the marks that I just made on your wall. That's helpful. Another pencil. They're everywhere. Hanging on the outside of my bucket, I've got my go-tos. There's a couple of razor blades in here, which I have loosely packed so that I can hurt myself when I go digging around in there. The drill bits that I use, various sizes, and things that are going to get lost in the larger bucket that I need on a regular basis. I keep them in this nice little box tethered to the side. Tape measure usually goes in there. These are neat. When you use a tap con or something to hang into a block wall, it doesn't leave you with a hook. And these little guys are hooks that you can screw through. And that's nice. So I've got those hidden in here. I think I've used two of these in my lifetime. But when you need them, I got them. I also have business cards in here somewhere, but I could never find those. A little kit of plastic wall anchors and screws. This is a helpful tool that makes me look professional too. This is a laser level. So that puts a nice, probably can't see it in this light, puts a nice red laser line on the wall that automatically levels, so I can hang a whole group of pictures all at the same height. That's very handy. Invaluable tool. That's something that if you are hanging multiple things on one wall, it's a definite need, that one. Another kit of wall anchors, larger size. I have a large variety of wall hangers in this kit. This is where it starts getting impressive. My wife put this together for me in a little tackle box so I can stay organized, but I have my 50-pound picture hangers, which are very common. 100-pound picture hangers, a lot less common, but nice to have. Some more wall anchors, the tapcons for going into concrete block walls, and these are great, great screws. They're self-tapping, so when I use a metal stud or even a wood stud, this goes right into the wall without complaining. Great little tool, and I have a special drill bit for that in my little hanger so that I can just zip right into the wall, no problem at all. So that's this is my heavy kit. As you can see, it's labeled on the side. I'm not this organized, my wife is. This is my lighter duty kit, but I have a lot of great things in here. 30-pound hangers, 20-pound hangers, the T-screws that I use for locking pictures to the wall in commercial areas, nails. Sometimes you get pictures with little saw teeth on the back, and it's just easier to just tap a nail in the wall and use it that way. If I need to, I've got the little rings that I use to put wires on pictures and various screws. That's a handy little kit. Oh, and that's a fun little one too. This is more plastic wall anchors, my rubber wall bumpers, because you always seem to lose them. So that's something you should have a couple of. Masking tape is always handy too when in a hanging situation. You never know. Again, if you're on a wall that your pencil doesn't show up or your chalk pencil doesn't show up, you can put a little piece of masking tape on the wall and mark it with a pencil then. And then you would have no problem. Well, that looks like just about it for the hanging kit. Well, it always seemed like there was a lot more than that in there. But anyway, oh, I do have... I didn't show you earlier because it's a commercial thing, really, but it's my key to lock and unlock pictures from the wall using those T-screws. That's a nice little tool. I always have one of those around. You never know when you go to a restaurant and there's a broken picture on the wall. I can just walk over, undo it, and walk out and fix it for them. I've been known to do that. But that's what's in my hanging kit. Hopefully you find this helpful, maybe a little humorous. Anything will help. If you do, like it, share it, and we'll survive this quarantine together. So we'll see you again tomorrow for another video on how to hang pictures. Thanks a bunch. I'm Ken from Wally World Gallery in Ormond Beach.